Now on Home Design, Hamish is here with a great easy solution to livening up the entrance to your home with adding a splash of colour to your front door. Morning, Hamish.
Morning, guys.
So this sounds good. It sounds like a great idea, something you could maybe do, I don't know, say DIY over Queen's birthday weekend?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Doing something like that over Queen's birthday weekend is a great opportunity. It doesn't take much to change the impact of the front of the house by changing the front door colour.
So what are your top tips then for doing it yourself?
Okay, top tip is make sure you're actually going to be home, because when you paint the front door, you want to leave it open.
Oh, right. That's a good tip.
Actually, that's great,
it's a basic one, but a goodie, because I've seen it. And then people go out like 2 hours later and they think it's fine. They shut the front door
and then they can't open it again.
Yeah, or either that or it's got like foam stuck to the outside where the draft stops adhered to it. Once again, it comes down to prep, so you need to think about what your door's been made of from the first place. You know, if it's a natural timber sort of finished door that a lot of them went in the early 90s, they've probably just been polyurethaned, so you're going to need to do a fair bit of prep work to it as well. A great tip that I would love everyone to do is paint the underneath of the door. Now, yes, this is quite difficult to do with it on the hinges. You might want to take it off, because you know how your door swells in the winter and it doesn't shut properly and it jams? That's because 90% of doors aren't painted on the bottom, so the moisture from the sill, it soaks up. It swells, door jams. Yeah, you got to give it the kick. So if you don't want to give it the kick, give it, you can just undercoat it, lazy. But if you can, I'd love you to put a little bit of top coat on it as well.
Why? No one's going to see it.
There it is.
It's the moisture that comes up. Yes. Okay, well, we've got the prep sorted. We know what we're doing. Okay. Let's talk colour.
Okay, so pops of colour on your front door. We're going to have a look at some images for you. These are Resina, but just so an area you can actually start is you can actually jump online and actually Google it. Right, there's a whole host of front doors. Okay. Now, some of those would be better off in Cuba because they really like their bright coloured front doors. There's a red. Resina have changed the same front area. That's the same place with the black on it. You notice the trim's grayed off a bit. There's used some orange. I kind of like that because they've used lemon for the colour of the house.
Right.
And I think that's something you need to start considering is what is the actual colour of your house if you're just going to paint the front door. And when you actually start choosing your colour, it's not a case of going, right, I'm going to have orange. There are a lot of oranges. You really want to think about what orange is going to suit the style and nature of your front
and
of your house.
And how much dirt, because, you know, kids' fingers and dirt and
dogs.
Stuff like
children
that.
Children are dirty, dirty creatures.
Sorry, you go.
No, I've got a quick question. My neighbour came over the other day,
yes,
and he had just finished painting his roof, and he didn't know what colour to paint his door. And I said, oh, match it with your roof. And when he finished, it looked quite good. But
yeah,
what would your tip be?
Yeah, matching with your roof can actually be okay. Often, if you're doing things like garage doors, I'll tone that through, depending on what your colourways you can get at. Okay, colour-wise for front doors, I'm going to show you some samples that I like later on. Where I would be saying is you don't always have to define your front door area by using orange, bright yellow, blue. You can use grey. Thank you. See, grey can be clean and crisp, and you can use a door that's got a pattern. There you've got a blush pink.
Oh, I like that.
So it doesn't have to be intense to invite it. Green, I love. Green's my favourite colour.
That is intense, though.
Well, it isn't, and it isn't. It's not like bright pink or super orange. You can think about things like this. Black front doors, for example,
which everyone knows,
the black front door. Now, if you've got an older home, I'd rather you actually brushed your black front door rather than getting it down to be sprayed, because brushing, you can do yourself. You can hire a spray unit. I'd advise against it.
Okay, I want to move you on a little tiny bit.
I'm
because
rambling.
I just want to know, if you're a little bit overwhelmed by choice, is there some sort of fixed rule, like this goes with woodwork, this goes with brick, this goes with stucco?
You do need to think about it. If you've got a timber house and it's painted weatherboard, you're really going to go with a painted front door.
Right.
If your house is stained, I'd probably be using a darker stain than the cladding of the house, if that's possible, if it's not black. I'd go down the road of stain. Brick, you want to tone your colours with the brickwork. So whatever colour you choose is fine. See, in that example there, I would probably rather you painted the front door than left it natural like that.
Okay, tell me more about stains.
Okay, I have a couple of options. Now, everyone thinks stains is going to end up being natural sort of coloured and finished. Think outside the square. We have one here. I'm going to hold it up. Ooh,
nice.
Look at that. Okay, this is lime dash. I like it. It's kind of a grey sort of washed finish to it.
Yep.
A little bit of interest. If you do want to go darker with it, I quite like this. This is heading down your blacker area, but without doing a black front door, and this is called Banjul.
Okay, not black, Banjul.
Banjul, yeah. So I guess I like stain. There's a natural softness to it, but I would rather it with a stained house.
Where did these stains come from?
Oh, these are resin ones. These are my favourite picks of colours. Mm. Do we have time for me to go through those?
Oh, just fan them out like that.
Yeah, what are your favourite colours?
Oh, crikey, George. Okay, don't be afraid of having a white front door should you actually have a grey house. White front doors can then stand out and not be too intense.
How often should you be looking at painting it too?
Well, if you do it right, it should last you a fair few years.
Okay.
It should be in high gloss too, is my preference. Obviously, if it's stained, it's not going to be.
Dear
slightly
fan.
Darker grey. Oh,
come
crikey
on.
Dickens.
You're running out of time.
Grays,
do you want to see them all?
Light grey.
Yes.
There's a green worth considering if you've got a white house. You can do something with green. Red. This is Pohutukawa. I like this red, folks. Why? It's not too bright. And it's called Pohutukawa.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. Nice. Hey, all available from Racine, no doubt. Thank you, Racine. Have over 6,000 different colours to choose from. You can head in-store or go to racine.co.nz for more. Thank you, Hamish.